Sometimes you just want to update the same line with new text without going down one line. In today's video, we're gonna have a look at how you can do that. All right, guys, so I'm gonna start by importing time, which we're gonna use, all right? And then I'm gonna print a few things normally, all right? So, hello, and time, sleep, 2 seconds, print. I am Fabio, time.sleep, and then plus one. All right, so let's just have a look at how Python does that normally, all right, without changing anything. So I'm going to save the file, open the terminal, and then I'm going to run Python. Right lines. All right, so let's have a look. Hello, I am Fabio. Welcome to my channel, right? So this is actually the default way. All right, so let's clear and keep going. So if you want to actually show these messages, right, without actually changing line, all right, so actually overwriting the previous one, you need to use the carriage return. So basically the carriage return moves the cursor at the beginning of the line so that the new string will be printed from the beginning of the line, right? Overwriting the previous one. All right, so the carriage return is this character, right? This, all right. So what's gonna happen here is that Python actually prints the hello, and then as there's this carriage return, the cursor will move from the end of hello to the beginning, all right, of the string. So it's gonna move here, right? And then it's gonna print I am Fabio, overwriting the hello. The same thing down here, all right? So let's have a look. Save the file, and then I'm gonna run this. So as you can see, it's not working. So why isn't it working? Well, because print has an argument, a keyword argument, which tells Python what to add at the end of each string printed. The default one is the line feed, all right? And the line feed is like hitting enter. So the cursor goes down one line automatically. So we need to fix that. So to fix that, we actually need to change that end like that. Like that, and like that. So basically here we are telling Python that we don't want anything printed after the string, all right? So the default one is actually this one, all right? So we're gonna delete that and leave an empty string as value, all right? So it's not gonna actually print anything. So I'm gonna save the file and see how it works. So I'm gonna leave it like that. Let's have a look. As you can see, we just have the last one because all the others have been overwritten. All right, perfect. There is still a problem when the strings that come after are shorter than the previous one. So let's have a look at what I mean. All right, so I'm gonna just comment this out. All right, I'm gonna write, I'm actually going to copy this. Uncomment it and change a few things. So do this. All right. So now I'm gonna make this longer. All right. So hello, I am Fabio. This a little bit shorter, like welcome, and then even shorter here. All right. So let's have a look at how it works. Pull up the terminal. All right. So I'm gonna clear this and let's see what happens. Right. It doesn't look right to me. So why is this happening? So basically, when the cursor moves from the end of the line to the beginning of the line, right, then it writes this string, but the other string is sort of beneath that, right? So for example, welcome has this length. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 characters. That means that 7 characters are going to be overwritten, but then the remaining part is going to stay there, all right? Because the cursor is actually here, right? And then there's the welcome here, and here has only 4 characters. That means that welk is going to be overwritten, but then the OME is not going to be overwritten, right? So as you can see here, OME, I am Fabio, right? So how can we actually fix this? There's a really simple way. So I'm going to show that to you right now. So you just need to add spaces at the end of the actual string. So if you do something like this, just random number of spaces, all right? So now the actual string is this long, all right? So this is definitely longer than this. So all the spaces here are gonna overwrite the remaining part of the string, and the same down here. So let's have a look at how it works. All right. As you can see, now it's working properly and how it's supposed to work, right? So you can actually do a thing like that. I'm gonna just copy and paste them down here and comment this out. Okay. You can actually add spaces in a different way. So you can do like spaces and then do something like, you know, times 10, all right? So 10 spaces, and then you can add them at the end of the string. So you can delete this. You can do like plus spaces, and the same here. You can do whatever you want to do. But I mean, this looks a little bit better to me. It's just my personal preference, all right? So let's see if it still works. Let's see. All right, perfect. Really important thing to know is that this method works only if the terminal's width is greater than the length of the string, right? Otherwise, if the terminal has the wrap text enabled, which is like a setting, the string is going to be cut in 2 or more lines and it won't work properly, all right? Because the cursor is like, let's say on the second line, and the new string will overwrite only that line and not the one above, all right? So maybe if I show you an example, you'll understand that better. So that's what I'm gonna do. So let's clear this up. So let's make this string really, really long. I'm just gonna add like things like that, you know, just to write something, right? So I'm actually making the strings really, really long, so they're actually gonna wrap. Save the file. So let's see what happens. So I'm gonna just narrow the terminal, right, like that. Let's try that out. All right, here what happens is that this is the first line, all right? Maybe the first line is like up to here, okay? But then the welcome has overwritten the third line. So actually the cursor probably was here, right? And then it started from the beginning of this line and then overwrote this line with the welcome. And then it went down here. This is actually the welcome string, but then the cursor was here and then it went here and started writing here like that. And then all the spaces, right? So it's not actually working properly because the cursor wasn't on the same line, right? So the cursor needs to be on the same line to work. Otherwise, it'll start from this line and then start from the beginning of this line, not actually this line. All right. Hopefully that makes sense. All right. So be careful when you are actually dealing with things like that, because you need to have the terminal's width greater than the length of the string, right? Or maybe you need to make sure that the terminal doesn't have the wrap text enabled, and then the thing is going to work properly because actually the text won't wrap, all right? So the line is going to be the same every time. All right, so hopefully that makes sense. All right, so I'm just going to do this. I don't really like that. I just did it to show you. And now I just want to actually have a look at another little example, all right? So let's comment this out. All right. And then let's have a look at, I don't know, like I've got a number and I want to print all the numbers up to, I don't know, like 100,000. Yeah. And then I'm going to print character return. Then format. Then I'm going to use the N, the number, and like that. Then here I'm going to actually add one to the number, save it, and let's see what we've got. I'm going to clear this. Let's have a look. So this is actually a little example to show you how you can use things like that. So you can actually count things and stuff like that. So that's a way you can use the carriage return. All right. So as you can see, I've just wrote the carriage return here, but you could have written the carriage return like here, all right, at the end of the string, because it prints a line and then at the end it adds the carriage return. And then so the cursor goes back to the beginning of the line, and then it prints another string, and then again the carriage return. So either way actually works. I'm going to save that. So, all right, I'm going to just close everything as usual. And that's it, guys.